Gather round and hear my tale. It's the story of an island not so far away, where people lived happy, normal lives. Then tragedy struck. They made a sacrifice, hoping to put an end to their woes. Instead, the moon turned from blue to red, and a shadow began to take the villagers' lives. It has lurked about their homes ever since. You may think it's just a story, but there's truth in every fable.
Thanks for coming, Pamela. It's been too long. Nora's so glad you're coming for her birthday. Whoa, easy, boy. Whoa, easy, boy. Okay, Pam. I don't know what that was, but I gotta calm my horse down. You mind fixing the wheel? I've got a bag of tools on the cart. This opens it.
Thank you.
Thanks for your help. We should head home. It's getting late. Also, I'd appreciate it if you didn't tell anybody about this, understand? You go on in. I'll tie up my horse. Nora and Mrs. Stewart are waiting for you.
Hi, I'm Nora. Nanny told me all about you. Did you really meet the gods? And that Minotaur too?
Nora, dear, let the poor woman breathe a moment. Do forgive her manners, Miss Pamela. She's all wound up. I'm Miss Stewart, Nora's nanny. Shall I show you to your room for the night?
Wait, not yet. Can you help me finish my birthday cake, Miss Pamela? It's almost done. We just need some blue dye for the frosting. Can't she please, Nanny?
Well, I suppose. It is almost your birthday, after all. There's some blueberries growing outside. Here, you may borrow my pruners.
It's perfect. Thank you. I'm not good at decorating, but I drew this from my memory.
Now that everything is ready for your party, we should all get some sleep. My leg. I think it's broken. I can't move it. Pamela, you're my last hope. I beg you, please save Nora. That was a demon who has a grudge against the McConnell family. She haunts the old estate on the island near Aberloch. Something horrible happened there 11 years ago. I hid the estate key in the statue outside. Find it and go to the estate. Don't worry about me. Just go, please. Hurry.
Hey, what are you doing out here alone? Where's your parents?
Help!
Help! evening. What's got you in such a rush?
A monster took my niece. I have to save her.
Lots of talk about monsters and demons tonight. The puppeteer gave a show about the banshee of the McConnell estate. He wouldn't let anyone near his cart. Very suspicious. Then that man in the corner ran in like he'd seen a ghost.
Interesting. I'll talk to him.
He's the only one who'll sail near the Banshee's Island. And if you get the chance, keep an eye out for my friend, Mr. Whiskers. We've got the same eyes. Maybe my lucky charm can help. Please, take it.
Want to talk about the demon? Maybe after a game of jugs. The wager is a coin, of course.
Beginner's luck. Beginner's luck. Beginner's luck.
Yeah, I saw the demon with the girl. Now that strange monster is blocking me from loading the goods onto my ship. You say you want to sail to the estate?
Yes, I have to get to the McConnell estate. The little girl is my niece. I have to save her.
How brave. I'll take you anywhere you want if you chase away that thing on the road.
It's a deal. I'll help you, and you'll return the favor.
Eleven years ago, sorrow came to the McConnell estate. The master's young wife passed away shortly after giving birth to a daughter. The villagers blamed the tragedy on the servant girl and burned her alive.
Thank you.
Mr. Whiskers, thank you. Is your niece really on that island? Take this. It belonged to an old friend who used to ferry people to and from that wretched place.
You did it! I'm a man of my word, but I'll need a map and coordinates to sail there at night. I'll load up the ship while you get ready.
What's that?
Hold on.
Thank you. Thank you. Corn? Are you surprised to see us human? Our sacred tree has protected us from the evil aura here for many years. But that foul cat has stolen its heart. Without it, it has become weak. It will need an elixir. You're big and strong. I'm sure you could get it back for us. I can repay you with this jewel.
The girl named Blair arrived on a dark and windy day when clocks were striking one. She had left her sorrowful past behind and sailed from a faraway land. She was kind as a dove and beautiful as a rose, but soon rumors began that she sang the song of death. The villagers feared she would bring calamity to their lives. Only the McConnell family offered her shelter. She was finally happy, but when the sun set, she felt something dark lurking underground. For the sake of the family, she tried to seal the gates to this evil source and hoped that her magic could restrain it for an eternity.
Human. Here, this amulet came from the servant girl who used to help us. Be careful, there's a powerful demon below.
Thank you for saving me. The Kelpie ensnared my soul with his magic and forced me to bring him those poor people's souls. Now he wants to make Nora his servant too. Find the magical artifact in the treasury and use it together with the amulet gems to destroy him. My soul will help you on your way.
You all right? Please, come with me. You are the only human we trust. The shaman will tell you everything.
I'm sorry for stealing you away, but we are desperate. A monstrous cat has crippled the heart of our tree. I don't know if it's poison or a curse, but the tree's suffering weakens us all. Please, use this book to... I'm still not certain what caused this, but perhaps this will weaken the curse. If not, I'll need a sample from the heart. Some thistle milk and a strip of bark so we can learn more.
Richard McConnell was an adventurer who loved nature. On one of his journeys, he found a unique tree and searched the bushes for a seed to bring back. The tree goblins were the protectors of the sacred tree, and they hid in Richard's bag to carry out their duty. After returning home, he planted and watered the seed, and it grew into a wonderful shelter. The tree goblins went unnoticed until a cat captured one. Luckily, the servant girl intervened. She looked after them until the fateful tragedy that left the mansion abandoned. Not long ago, a magic crystal corrupted the cat's heart. He commanded the loyalty of the rats and cursed the heart of the tree, which can be saved only by destroying the crystal.
I should have known the curse was tied to that wicked crystal. Our only option is to destroy the crystal with the juju. Can you summon a bird and fly to the attic where the crystal is? Please hurry.
Tree goblins send you to save them again? Oh, you and the bird should stay for dinner. You can be, oh, I don't know, the main course!
Mm.